How do we say this with our actions? Well, I'll give you very practical examples. How do we say I love my job more than Allah? Well, when I see that I'm going to make more profit by selling alcohol, I go ahead and sell alcohol. If I see that I'm going to make more profit by taking an interest, you know, or dealing in interest or taking an interest-bearing loan, I do it. Because in my heart, what do I love more? If I see, for example, one of the things is our homes. One of it is our homes. If I see that it's more important to me that I have a big, humongous, fancy house that people can look at and say, look at that person's house, and my image is more important than my love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then I'm going to choose that route. My car. You know, in the Quran, one of the things in Surah Al-Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, زُيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ حُبِّ الشَّهَوَاتِ مِنَ النِّسَاءِ وَالْبَنِينَ وَالْقَنَاطِيرِ الْمُقَنْطَرَةِ. Now, in this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala lists many things that are that decorate our dunya. And among those things is well-branded, like horses and stuff. And you know here, like it used to be horses, the branded horses. Now it's Mercedes and BMWs because it's just a different type of ride, but it's that branded ride. So these are the things Allah is mentioning in the Quran, that these are the things that decorate our dunya. But these are not the things that matter. These are just, you know, when something is decoration, like if you look in this room, there's like the walls, there's the bricks, there's the floor, the ground, and the ceiling, and then there's these lights. And the lights are really insignificant because they're just there for decoration. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He describes the dunya in that, using that same term, zina, zuyina. It's just decoration. It's not actually the substance. It's not actually what matters. So why it becomes very difficult is because it is within these halal things. It's not like, well, we know, okay, having a haram relationship, dating, okay, this is haram, right? We don't date, we don't have a girlfriend, we don't have a boyfriend. But what about when it's your spouse? Now it becomes much more hidden that I actually love my spouse more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It becomes much more hidden that I actually love my father or my mother more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or as I should love Allah, or my children. This is a big test, because how do I love my children more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Well, I might say, well, really, I'm very concerned about my children's future. Let me set up a savings account for them. And this savings account is interest bearing. But I am, my concern and my love and my fear for protecting my children is greater than my fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for dealing in interest. So you understand how we don't need to speak it with our tongue, but in our actions we really do love other things as we should only love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So a heart that is salim is a heart that's free of these things. It's a heart that loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger and striving in His cause more than everything else. Even the halal things that we legitimately love. That's what's so interesting about this ayah that describes and lists these things, is all of them are legitimately loved. Our fathers, our children, our spouses, our jobs, all of them are halal and it's legitimate to love. But the problem is when we love these things as we should love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is where we get into the concept of attachments. Attachments are things that that I depend upon as I should only depend on Allah. There are things that, how do you know that you have an attachment to something other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or something is taking that spot that only Allah should have? One question you can ask yourself is, what occupies my mind most?